happens when this lead comes in, right? And my favorite thing to do is to build a short, when I first construct a campaign, a short conversation starting campaign. So there's that term again, that cost per conversation starting campaign in KV Core based on that hashtag. So I'm going to build one of those out for you now. And you guys are going to be appalled and stunned at how little is in this, how little content you need in a drip campaign. The reason I'm saying that, Joe, is because everybody's always like, where can I get drip campaign templates? Right? Isn't that like a very common question?
Thing,
like,
for sure.
I want a 3-year, you know, fire nurture campaign, which
oddly enough, that's me. And James is probably laughing because he knows that that's true. And
And you could do that, but I think there's better ways to do this longer term drip. Let's build our smart campaign. And we'll get into that a little more. All right. So I'm going to add a campaign. We'll do the scope. I'm seeing the scope because I'm an admin on this account. It's not really important. You probably won't see that, but just choose my name here. Now, remember, we put new construction as our hashtag. So you're going to trigger it off that hashtag. I typed new construction X because I don't want this to override the one I built earlier. But you're going to put the hashtag in that's coming in off your landing page. I'm going to leave it as always run. Campaign design for a buyer. New construction demo is my name. KV Core makes you put this description in. I usually just put a couple of dots. It's kind of redundant. You don't need it. And hit finish. And then now that you've created the campaign, feel free to stop me, Joe, if somebody chimes in and I'm moving too fast. But
the good news is it's recorded. Here. We're recorded and, you know,
okay, good.
There's a balance, right? We want to get into the weeds, but not too much in the weeds, because I know showing someone this could take a full hour, right? So your pace is spot on.
Okay. So always remember to turn the campaign on. It's not on by default, so I just toggled it on real quick. Is this the same one? It doesn't matter. It's the same one I just built. So usually what I do in my conversation starting campaigns is when I first run the ad, I just put two actions. I put an initial text and an initial email. That's it. And I'm not worried about the longer term drip. I'll explain why in our next step. So I'm going to do an initial text. And I'm just going to say, hi. You can merge in the first name if you have it. Usually you'll have it on a Facebook ad, not so much with the landing pages. Hi, thanks for checking out the new construction list just now. Did you end up having any questions about any of the properties? Now, this question right here, there's kind of a template at work. So it's hi, and then you acknowledge what they just did so they know why you're texting them. So check, thanks for being able to just listed this, the list. And then you ask an open-ended question or an either-or question. So I've been doing this, did you end up? Because I don't know if it's still there, but you can stop KV Core's automatic unsubscribe. You guys know about this hack?
Something, yeah. Yeah, I've heard of it. I'm sure James knows a little better, but please explain.
Yeah. Somebody told me it might not still be working. You know, I haven't worked there in over a year. But there's a few words, stop and unsubscribe. If you put them in the body of your very first text, it stops KV Core from adding the additional reply stop to unsubscribe language. So you get less unsubscribes. So there's help documentation about that. I don't know if it's like if you search SMS or something, it's just a little hack. But that's why I put the word end in there. Sometimes I say, thanks for stopping by. You can do stopping and I separate the two P's in stopping.
Oh, how awesome.
So my broker asked me, like, after like a year, we had something running forever. And she's like, there's a typo in there. And I'm like, no, it's on purpose. That's why I'd say it.
That's a good
stopping.
One.
Stopping. So
that's a good one.
Yeah. Did you end up having any questions about the properties? Another good one is, do you already live in St. Pete? Or are you moving from somewhere else? So this is a good question, especially in a market like mine where we have a lot of people, you know, coming from vacation homes or something. If your market's like that, you can ask if they already live there. But if you have a lot of people who live there already, just, you know, ask a different question. So the idea here is to get that 10% or more of people just responding to you, just talking to you in some way. So we just put instruction quick. First text, you have to do these settings up here from agent to contact. And then you can let this one run immediately like that. So text, kind of redundant, but you have to do that. And then the email is very similar, but in the email, I give the list. So, hey, thanks for checking out the new construction list. Click here to access the list anytime. It's always up to date. You mentioned that it's a dynamic link. Okay. So I'm not going to make you guys watch me do that. I think you get it. An email and a text right away to try to get the response. So that's kind of our short-term right away conversation starting stuff. There is a conversation starting campaign template in KV Core that's got a couple extra emails. I wrote this a couple years ago. I think on day 4, it asks if they own a home in the area to try to get you a listing. On day 7, it's like, hey, are you okay with the listings I've been sending you? So you can add a few more touches, but just these two, when you first run the campaign and you're testing it, will get you pretty far. The next thing you want to do for follow-up is always make sure that you have property alerts triggered. So I don't know, and you guys don't have to raise your hands, but if you're not setting pretty much anybody who comes into your database up for some kind of automated property alert, even if it's a past seller, even if it's a guy you went to high school with that you talked to on Facebook, you'll get his permission to send hey buddy, can I send you $1 million homes? It's a lot of fun, right? Because that's probably the most interesting content you can send, right? That's related to real estate to keep you top of mind is some kind of alert in their inbox, which is cool properties nearby that gets them clicking on stuff and getting the brain, what do they call that? You know, the connections in their brain associating real estate to you. Mm-hmm. You know, you're like, so automated alerts, the way you can automate that with KV Core is you go to marketing, all marketing, search alerts, and then this is so easy to do. Remember our hashtag was new construction.
Yep.
So you just say, hey, anytime this hashtag comes in, send, I can pick single family, the different property types, but mostly I'm just going to go down here to where the options were. Here it is. And do newly built. And I might just do single family homes and condos or something. Frequency, daily. And then I have to remember to put my county in here. So now, anytime somebody opts into that landing page, they're going to get any new properties that fit that criteria for me every week or every day if I have it on daily. And to me, that's your long-term drip. That's pretty good long-term drip campaign. That's your generic. That's just as good as having something you buy off of a vendor that just was like, hey, here's a home buying tip. This is my opinion. I know that stuff works fine too. But in the spirit of money following speed and acting quickly and just getting things done, property alerts. Now, at this point, you've got a pretty full funnel. You have a traffic source from Google. You've got a place to capture the contact info with your landing page. And you've got some basic follow-up, an initial text and initial email, and you have a longer-term follow-up in the form of property alerts.